Hi everyone, Paul here from familywheels.ca with another car review for your growing family. And I have lost my voice here this week, but at least I'm driving around in style in this, the latest Lexus ES, which, depending who you ask, either stands for elegant sedan or executive sedan, but either totally apply here in this car. It's been a staple of the Lexus family since 1989 and has always remained true to that smooth, comfortable focus. And for 2019, it's seen a total redesign, making this the seventh generation of this car. Yeah, it's got some pedigree at this point. It's looking a little bit edgier here compared to the outgoing version, which was rather conservative. Lexus has also upped the fun factor here, making it a much more dynamic ride, especially if you pile on the new optional F Sport packages, and standard equipment has also been further improved. So if the old ES didn't seem quite exciting enough for you, Lexus is really flipping the script here for 2019. Stick around and I'll tell you all about it this week here on Family Wheels. So I'd never heard this term before, but Lexus Canada staff that I spoke with call the new ES their entry flagship, which, when you think about it, is kind of an oxymoron. Generally, the term flagship is reserved for the most high-end vehicles in a company's lineup, really showing off what that brand can do. But I kind of see what they're saying here, because there's a lot of new stuff in the ES for 2019, and since it starts at $45,000 Canadian, it's also aggressively competitive. First up, it looks so much more interesting for 2019. Lexus calls its latest design approach provocative elegance, and that's pretty fitting, I think, here, because that spindle grille off the front, that sweeping coupe-like roofline, all the careful little attention to detail on the interior, bringing in all kinds of different materials and textures into the cabin, just really make it pop. It's also an ever so slightly bigger car for this year, 2.5 inches longer than the outgoing version, just over 1.5 inches wider, but also just a tiny bit lower for better handling. But the big news for drive feel for 2019 is that the ES is the first Lexus vehicle to adopt the company's new global design platform. We've seen this getting picked up in Toyota cars for a few years, and now Lexus is jumping on board. The payoff is a smooth, refined, composed, and still pretty sporty ride. It's also really quiet. We're averaging a stellar 61 decibels at 100 kilometers an hour this week, despite having winter tires on board. And while the Insurance Institute for Highway Safety hasn't released safety tests on this car yet, all these latest platforms have been coming out with excellent results. The previous ES had a top Safety Pick Plus rating, and I don't expect this seventh generation car to be any different. There's another first for Lexus on board this new ES as well, and that's that it's the first car from the company to have Apple CarPlay. It comes as standard now, and it is a little late to the party compared to a lot of other competitors out there, but it's, you know, better late than ever. However, if you've got an Android, you're still out of luck. Android Auto isn't an option on any Toyota vehicle yet, but the company has just announced that they've made a deal with Google, so we should see it coming in vehicles in the near future, but not this ES. Also new for 2019 is the latest generation of the Lexus safety system with pre-collision braking, adaptive cruise, and lane keep assist. And while I've found these systems in Toyota and Lexus cars to be a little bit jerky and twitchy compared to others out there in the past, they're now really responsive and smooth. Even in stop and go traffic, I think it's one of the best systems that's now out there. In terms of powertrain, we've always had a V6 in the ES since it was released back in 1989, and that's no different here for 2019. And if you're wary of the four-cylinder turbo revolution that's really taking over right now, I know there are a lot of you out there, this is a more traditional option that's really proven itself in both Toyota and Lexus cars for years. So as tested here, we've got the ES350, and it's got the same 3.5-liter V6 that we find in the Toyota Camry, pumping out 302 horsepower through an all-new 8-speed automatic transmission. Of course, staying away from turbos means that off-the-line performance is immediate with no pesky turbo lag, and it's more than powerful enough for confident passing on the highway. The downside is fuel efficiency. Lexus says that you should see 7.2 liters per 100 kilometers on the highway or 10.6 liters per 100 kilometers in the city. We've stuck mostly to urban roads this week and we've averaged 10.2 liters per 100 kilometers, which is 23 US miles per gallon. And that's not going to win any prizes on fuel economy. But what's cool is that the hybrid version of the ES, the 300H, which has a four-cylinder engine paired up with an electric motor, is now just $1,500 more expensive, with a starting price of 47 grand Canadian. And with an anticipated fuel economy of around 5.3 liters per 100 kilometers, that's 44 US miles per gallon, it makes it a fuel-sipping luxury choice, but it's not breaking the bank. Interesting to see, though, that this car's biggest competitor, the Acura RLX, is now strictly available as a hybrid. But Acura has made it a bit more of a sporty hybrid choice, coupling up a lively V6 to two electric motors, giving you 75 more horsepower than this V6 ES that we're driving right now. That's an interesting call by Acura, giving you a very sporty car to drive and far better fuel economy despite coming standard with all-wheel drive. The downside on the RLX, though, is that it has a starting price $20,000 more expensive than this Lexus. And I gotta hand it to Lexus here, despite what is a really competitive starting price, standard equipment here on the ES is excellent. We have all of those autonomous safety features that I've already talked about as standard. So are ventilated and heated front seats, which are also 10-way adjustable, by the way. We have a smart key with push-button start, an 8-inch infotainment system screen with Apple CarPlay now, paddle shifters, a new digital instrument cluster in front of the driver, LED headlights. That's all really good. But if you want real leather rather than faux leather, or this much larger 12.3 inch infotainment system screen, which looks totally kick-ass, or if you want a heated steering wheel, blind spot monitoring, a wireless charging dock for your phone, a panorama sunroof, you're gonna have to start looking at additional packages. Now, this ultra luxury package that we're driving here brings up our as tested price to nearly $60,000 Canadian, but that gives you a 17 speaker sound system, foot sensing trunk release, a heads up display projected on the windshield, and a 360 degree parking camera on top of all that other stuff that we've already talked about. And then, of course, what has the sporty set excited for 2019 are the two new F Sport packages, giving you things like an F Sport steering wheel, engages, a rear spoiler, F Sport seats, adaptive suspension, and bigger 19-inch wheels. But if you're a real driving purist, all these packages still won't make up for the fact that it's a front-wheel drive car. No matter what trim you get, that's the only setup that it's got. Now, I'm finding that it handles beautifully, but there are those who'd much rather get into an all-wheel drive or even more hardcore rear-wheel drive GS car from Lexus. Again, though, it's a much more expensive vehicle than what we have here. Lots of bang for your buck in the ES. Now, when it comes to the cabin in here, I found the previous generation of the ES just a bit bland. I mean, the materials were still phenomenal, as they always are in Lexus vehicles, but it was kind of stodgy. But no more. Here in this latest generation, it looks fantastic. And everything feels really good under your hands as well, with one exception, which is the paddle shifters, which feel a bit chintzy, like you'd expect to find them on an $80 video game steering wheel. It would be great if they just had a little bit more heft. Now, the biggest issue that I had with the outgoing ES were its seats, which were rather flat-bottomed and unsupportive, but that has been more than rectified for 2019. You could cruise all day in this car. One thing that hasn't been addressed here is the infotainment system interface. Such a gorgeous, clear screen here on the upper level trims, and you have to navigate your way through it with this ancient feeling, unintuitive trackpad. Just way too many menus and steps to do even just really simple things. And while it's cool that we now have wireless charging as an option, I'm finding it a little bit finicky to get my phone in and out of the wireless charging dock here, which would get on my nerves if I was doing that 10 times a day as an owner. Now, jumping into the back seat on this car, that extra bit of overall length means that the new ES has just about an inch more rear legroom. It was a comfortable second row before, and now it's even better. And while I was worried about that, you know, sleek coupe-like roofline, it has plenty of headroom for adults too. Our rear-facing car seat test comes out with a rock-solid 30 inches from the back of the front passenger seat up to the glove box, so there will be more than enough room, and the car seat anchor points back there are really easy to access. Now, optional back there are a whole slew of different shutters for keeping the sun out, but when you put up the sunshade for the back window, there's this big bar that just blocks your rearward visibility, and I wish that that bar would go up just a little bit higher to get out of the way so they wouldn't affect my sight lines quite so much. Now, at the back end of this car, the auto lift trunk does take its sweet time, but once it is open, there's tons of room to play with. 473 liters is more than enough room for our standardized trunk test, which is a stroller, diaper bag, two bags of groceries, a backpack, and a soccer ball. It's also really cool to see that we have a center pass-through in here for longer items, but be forewarned that it is tiny. Even a single pair of powder skis is probably not going to make its way through there, so it may not be quite as usable as you'd think. Now, if you're thinking of going with the hybrid version of the ES, some good news for 2019, because it used to be that you didn't have as much space back there because a lot of the trunk space was gobbled up by batteries, but now in the 308, it has exactly the same trunk space as what you see here in the regular ES. Well, while I liked the ES before, I really like it now for 2019. And while 48 grand at its starting price or 60 grand as tested here is by no means chump change, it feels far more premium than that price suggests while still offering up legendary Lexus reliability. And it's also great to see that the price differential between the standard V6 and the hybrid models here is tightening up a little bit. The more fuel efficient option all of a sudden isn't prohibitively more expensive like we see in some of its competitors. There's a lot of good packed into this latest edition of the ES. Now, next time, a review that you have been clamoring for, the 2019 Forester. I'll tell you all about it a week from now, right here on Family Wheels.